give me a second or wait a second is a very common phrase. But do you know how long is a second? It might seem obvious at first. A second is the tick of a clock, the swing of a pendulum, the time it takes to count to one. But how precise are those measurements? What is the length based on? And how can we scientifically define this fundamental unit of time? The Gregorian calendar defined a day as a single revolution of the earth about its axis. Each day could be divided into 24 hours, each hour into 60 minutes, and each minute into 60 seconds. However, when it was first defined, the second was more of a mathematical idea than a useful unit of time. It wasn't until society became interconnected through fast-moving railways and airplanes that cities needed to agree on exact timekeeping. By late 1950s, numerous global systems required every second to be perfectly accounted for with as much precision as possible. On October 4, 1957, the Soviet Union launched the Earth's first artificial satellite, and the United States launched its first satellite on January 31, 1958, and the race for the space was on. These satellites needed a precise timing device to launch them in the right orbit, but the search for precise clock was still on the drawing board. And what could be more precise than atomic scale? The first atomic clock was an ammonia absorption line device built in 1949 at the US National Bureau of Standards. It was less accurate than existing quartz clocks, but served to demonstrate the concept. A crystal of quartz has two properties that help it keep time. It retains energy very well and it is piezoelectric. When a crystal is bent slightly, it generates a charge. Conversely, apply a difference in charge across it and the crystal will deform slightly. When tapped, the crystal will vibrate like a tuning fork and create an oscillating charge. This charge is used as a timer. It can also be used as a guide, allowing the watch mechanism to tap the crystal at the right time to keep the oscillation going. In nearly all modern quartz clocks, the quartz crystal resonator or oscillator is in the shape of a small tuning fork, laser trimmed to vibrate at 32,768 Hz. As early as 1955, researchers began to develop atomic clocks, which relied on the laws of physics to establish a new foundation for timekeeping. An atom consists of negatively charged electrons orbiting as a positively charged nucleus at a consistent frequency. The laws of quantum mechanics keep these electrons in place. And if you briefly tweak an electron at just the right frequency, you can create a vibration that resembles a ticking pendulum. Unlike regular pendulums that quickly lose energy, electrons can tick for centuries. Some atoms can oscillate over 9 billion times per second, giving atomic clocks an unparalleled resolution for measuring time. But before timekeeping could go fully atomic, scientists had to decide which atom works best. There are 118 elements on the periodic table, each with their own unique properties. For this, the scientists were looking for several things. And the winning atom? Cesium-133. Cesium was already a popular element for atomic clock research. And all that was left was to determine how many ticks of a cesium atom were in a second. The cesium atoms used in the atomic clock were put in a position, the right temperature and pressure, that allows them to jump between a lower energy state and a slightly higher energy state. Apply a magnetic field, and it's possible to separate out the atoms that are in low energy state from the slightly higher ones. As a stream of cesium atoms run through the clock, a magnet does just this. It separates the low and high energy atoms and allows the atoms in the lower energy state to flow into the chamber with microwaves. When they pass through that second magnetic field, they go to a detector As the microwave approached the right frequency, more and more cesium atoms hit the detector. When the proportion of atoms hitting the detector hits its peak, the microwaves are at exactly the right frequency, which happens to be 9,192,631,770 Hz or cycles per second. The results formally defined 1 second at exactly that many ticks of a cesium-133 atom. In August 2004, NIST scientists demonstrated a chip-scale atomic clock. According to the researchers, the clock was believed to be 100 the size of any other, and it was suitable for battery-driven applications. In April 2015, NASA announced that it planned to deploy a deep space atomic clock, a miniaturized, ultra-precise mercury ion atomic clock, into outer space. NASA said that the ion-tapped deep space atomic clock would be much more stable than other cesium-based navigational clocks. Today, atomic clocks are used all over the Earth and beyond it. We can now count in 1 nanosecond or 1 billionth of a second. Though in normal life it seems silly to count such a minute time, but ask any Formula 1 driver, where every millisecond counts for a glorified win or a mere second place. GPS signals travels at a speed of light or about 300,000 km per second. 1 nanosecond or 1 billionth of a second delay in time can cause a position error of 300 meters. All GPS satellites have an atomic clock with a 9 billion Hz accuracy. And all your GPS receivers can synchronize with the clock of the satellite. So remember, the cesium atom has vibrated more than 9 billion times before you could finish saying, "Wait a second."